Hey, welcome to the Full Nerd Copy Text Edition. I'm here with AMD's Jim Anderson and the thing that just stole the show from everybody, which is this.
Threadripper Generation 2.
I am here with AMD's Jim Anderson. Sorry, my brain is a little fried because I'm just
There's just
floored.
So much good stuff.
I'm just
There's
floored.
So much good stuff.
There's so much good stuff. And I gotta say, because coming into Computex, you know, Intel has 20, you know, some other company has a 28 core part. We hear, you know, rumors it's in a reaction to AMD's 24 core part.
You think so?
I don't know. But then, so today the big news is you bust out this, which is
32 cores, 64 threads, and actually that's a production sample.
Yes.
So yeah, we didn't just come up with the 32 core last minute. That's a production sample. So
production sample, of course, means this is not made up, and it's really going to be coming soon, right?
You guys. We said Q3. Yeah, Q3 this year. Really excited to get it to market, get it to in the hands of our customers. Actually, Gordon, as you know, the system I use at home is Threadripper. So actually, I can't wait to upgrade my own system. Very nice. It drops into the existing TR4 socket. So if you've already got a Generation 1, you just pop it into the existing TR4 socket. BIOS update. We got to do a BIOS update.
But
Beforehand. Actually, most of those motherboards have the automatic BIOS update. Okay. Don't actually require a CPU. But so we're really excited about it. I've been waiting a long time to get this one to market. I've been really excited. So I love this product.
So what the crazy thing is, because when you announced Threadripper last year, this is a D-Lid part. We don't even need Debauer to do that for us. So folks, we've done it ourselves. Jim just did it.
We saved some time for it.
Yeah, we saved time. So there are 4 8-core dies on here.
Yep.
All of them hot.
Yep.
And so from the beginning, because you guys have always been a little coy, guys and gals have been very coy about answering, can you run all 4 dies hot? And yes.
Yeah, this is a full 32 core version. So in this version, all 4 dies are hot, connected through the AMD Infinity Fabric.
Right.
So the Infinity Fabric is really that magic fabric that allows the 4 die to communicate and essentially act as one big processor, right? So,
sure.
So all 4 die hot, and can't wait to get it into the market.
But I mean, clearly the motherboard was kind of like, there was a plan to like, okay, one day you may exercise this option.
Absolutely. So we can't talk about it until right now, right? I couldn't talk about it before. But yeah, we were always planning more than 16 cores. So actually, I always wanted to push the maximum amount of performance in the Threadripper socket. And so 16 core was our first step, and we were absolutely always had an intention to bring out a full 32 core as well. So it's kind of the fruition of actually a couple of years of planning. So,
Okay. Yep. Now you can't say the actual clock speeds of the part yet.
Not yet. I could say it, but I can't.
Well, you could say it, but
I shouldn't yet.
You would get in trouble. Lisa would come and yell at you.
Exactly. Yeah. So, but we'll talk about it as we get closer to the actual launch. But what I can say is, Ryzen, the second generation of Ryzen desktop processor, which launched just a couple months ago, that's based on our 12 nanometer technology. It's Zen Plus architecture. And so we got higher frequency, higher boost, et cetera. So Threadripper Generation 2 will inherit all that as well. So it is on 12 nanometer technology. It's got our Zen Plus core. So it'll have higher clocks, higher frequency.
Right.
Better performance per core. And then it's got the great Zen 2 or Generation 2 features like the better boost algorithm, et cetera.
Sure.
So it's, it should be a great part.
So all the goodness of Ryzen second generation, not Ryzen 2.
Yeah.
In a Threadripper.
In a Threadripper.
In all 4 dies.
Absolutely. Yep, and these are, as you know from Threadripper 1, these are the cherry-picked die, right? So
right.
We skim the best of the best, right, go into a Threadripper. So these are the top, tiny percent of the die get sorted out for Threadrippers.
Okay, so your demo, another company did a demo, all cores running at 5 gigahertz. I believe it was on a closed water loop, so fairly overclocked, I believe. I have not gotten details on it yet. The demo you just did.
Air-cooled.
Air-cooled completely.
Air-cooled, yeah.
Using in fact this, I believe.
Actually this, Gordon, I know how much you love coolers, right? Last time I talked to you, we spent most of the time talking about coolers, right? So so this is actually a specially designed cooler for Threadripper. I guess it'll work on in generation one or generation two, but it's from Cooler Master. They're gonna be selling it separately from the processor, so it's an option for people to buy, but it's designed specifically for Threadripper. It's air cooled. It's got some, of course I care about this, but it's got some really cool RGB lighting.
Sure.
So we don't have it plugged in right at the moment, but the RGB lighting on it is really neat. You can control it, etc. But yeah, this is what we were using in the demo, just regular old air cooling. We didn't want to use in our demos what I always say to the team is, like, I don't want to use any tricks in the demos. We want them to be straight up what a user would see, nothing special, unless we specifically are trying to do an overclocking demo. Otherwise, sure. We want it to be the real user experience, so you know kind of what you're getting. Yeah.
So it does speak to what kind of actual performance we're going to get out of it, because we're looking at actual, you know, end user, because this is, you're running it air cooled. You don't have to do it heavily overclocked, so.
Yeah, you don't have to heavily over, of course you can, right? Sure. It'll have overclockability. And if you really, you know, some users in this segment love water coolers, right? So they'll want to do their own liquid cooling. Actually, my Threadripper first generation system at home's got liquid cooling, right?
Sure.
So, but we wanted to have an air cooled option because actually this air cooler is pretty good, right?
Yeah.
And the performance it delivers is pretty good. So we wanted that option in the market as well.
Okay, and it's called Thread.
Wraithripper.
Wraithripper.
Did I get that right from the Wraithripper? Okay.
And just so you know, the little white lines that you can see here, they actually light up. I saw one of the demo units. Yeah. The logo lights up and the lines light up around here. So those are RGBs.
Cool.
So
cool.
12 heat pipe design. I want to ask, because the reaction from the internet, like for me, I love high thread count. It's sort of always been a dream of me. I started, you know, two processor systems and all that stuff. The reaction I got from some people was like, what the hell did people need? Of course, we sort of got that reaction last year when you pushed out Threadripper with 16 cores.
Yeah, but we got a great, but that 16 core is our most popular version. So we didn't just we didn't just put a 16 core out. You remember we put a 12 and an 8 out too. But by far, the highest selling version is the 16 core. So everybody's buying the 16 core. It's, you know, we sell some of the 8 and 12 as well, but definitely most popular is 16. So there's a need out there for more computing, more performance. There are a lot of, really high-end, very heavy-duty content creation applications that can take advantage of that number of threads. And look, if you're doing like high-end video, video creation or 3D modeling or 3D content creation, or you're doing audio mixing, anything that's got a lot of highly parallel threads, that Threadripper, 32 core is gonna be able to chew that up, right?
Right.
And the other way to think about it is it's 32 physical cores, right? 16 core had, 32 logical cores. This is now 32 physical cores, right? And then of course the extra multi-threaded. So I think people are really gonna appreciate it. I think there's gonna be a class of user that's been looking for this.
Sure,
right?
And I agree, because remember internet, AMD makes other chips too. There's a great chip, it's called the Ryzen 7 2700X.
If you don't want this many cores, we're perfectly happy if you buy the 8 core,
right?
For
those people who are building their own systems to be content creators at home, Dan here, our video editor, he has like a quad core at home. So like for him, it'd be great to get 32 cores to edit videos at home.
Yeah.
So there's definitely a real need, right? And is the messaging still sort of like, work in the day, play at night? So this will also have the great, Ryzen Master utilities, so you can get great game performance out of it too.
Yeah, absolutely. So it'll work with Ryzen Master. We'll have a couple new features that we'll introduce in Ryzen Master specifically for this generation. So we'll talk more about that as we get closer to launch. But look, what we want is for any customer, no matter what your price point is or your usage model, we want there to be a Ryzen that fits you, right? Some folks are perfectly happy with an 8 core or a 4 core, and some people want a 32 core. So we want a Ryzen for every budget, every application.
Okay. Jim's not going to answer this question. I'm going to ask it because I know you want to know. How much?
I can't say, right? But I will say soon as we get close to the launch, right? So it's launching in Q3, so we're not that far away, right? I will definitely talk about the price.
Okay.
So,
and it'll be...
We will definitely talk about the price before we start selling it.
Interesting. So, you know, I thought
you were going to ask me about frequency, too. Though.
Oh, frequency, too, yeah. What's the clock going to be? We already talked about...
We kind of already talked about that. We'll talk about clocks, too.
I mean, everybody kind of wants to know, like, because I mean, Threadripper 16 core was really wow, really sort of reset everything at that high end because, and the parts were down $800 after being on the market for a while, which is just such a super steal.
Oh, I agree.
I guess people are hoping that this is going to be that, but I it's hard for me to imagine it'll be. It feels like, oh, you won't say. I can speculate.
Well, it feels like a recommendation. I'll always take the feedback.
It feels like it'll coexist with lower core count parts, okay. Right? Because I think so. Everybody, like, you're right, because with Threadripper 1, it was really 16 cores or nothing for everybody, because, like, why not? It's like it's like a steal, right? You're going to give me two extra for another $50?
Yeah, absolutely.
Nobody ever buys the soda at the theater that isn't extra large for that 25 cents more, right? Yeah. So same thing. I kind of wondering if 32 will be the only thing that everybody buys, and nobody will care about the 24.
Yeah, we'll see. My guess is that the 16-core is still going to be popular, right? That our 16-core version of Threadripper will still be popular. We'll see, though. Maybe everybody might grades up to the 32 core.
Just wondering, so with 2700, you know, the second gen of the lower core count parts, they pretty much replace all of the first generation parts. Are we going to see the same thing with Threadripper, or are they going to coexist?
Well, actually, on second gen, the Ryzen desktop processors, we didn't completely replace. Actually, what we said is we'll replace some of the SKUs, some of the versions, but some of the first generation will continue to run because they're actually pretty popular. People are very happy with them. So the generation 2 and generation 1 will coexist for a while. I think you can expect the same with Threadripper for both generations to coexist.
Okay.
Yep.
I do want to know, where do you go from here? Because now I sort of thought AMD broke everything, all the rules with 16 core, and now 32 cores is like, are we going to be sitting here at Computex 2019 with the 64 core count Threadripper?
I don't know. We're going to have to come up with something for Computex next year, right? So, no, like, we've got a lot of good technology in the pipeline. I'm really happy about our roadmap. When I look at the next, actually, we've got our roadmap mapped out through 2022 and beyond. And when I look at that roadmap, I mean, I can't wait to get those products, right? I can't wait to upgrade my system with those, with what's on the roadmap. So it's exciting. And we'll have some good stuff next year.
Other questions. What do you think the reaction was? Because I think really everybody did expect that the 24-core part, which you did show off today as well.
Yes.
Do you want to guess, speculate what your competitors down the road were thinking as they watched the live stream today? Or because, I mean, really, I mean.
I don't know. I don't know what they were thinking. Okay. I don't know. I know that we...
frowny face? You know, emoji frowny face?
I know that we... anyway, I won't speculate.
All right.
I won't speculate.
He's being nice, folks. And, of course,
but
I do...
You know what I'll say, though, is I think if you step back from an industry perspective or from just a pure end-user perspective, right? Because I always tell my team, hey, let's always think about, let's start with the customer, right? And if we think about the customer, look, AMD back in the market, competing, driving new products, that is good for everybody, right? And I think, you know, Ryzen's been in the market just a little over a year, and the amount of impact it's had in the industry is, I think, pretty phenomenal for a product line that's only been in the market for a little over a year, right? And I think, again, I think it's AMD has this great history. If you go far enough back in its history, great history of driving new innovations to market, first 64-bit x86, right? First dual core to market, first to break what, the gig barriers.
Sure.
So a lot of industry first. I think AMD's back to that now, right? Back to its heritage of pushing the industry, pushing innovation, and that is good for everybody. But ultimately, who benefits the most is the end customer.
Okay. So, yeah. And last question I'm just going to ask, because actually I may have another question after this, but Z490 rumors.
No comment.
No comment. So, didn't even exist, folks. It didn't even exist. Just kidding. And so,
are you going to point out the T-shirt?
Oh yes, this is actually the very last thing I want to talk about.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to.
But check this out, though. So Jim is modeling for us the second generation.
This is the first time I've ever been called a model.
These models. Yes. My brother-in-law is actually a model, but you know, it's the heavy metal theme for Threadripper because you know, 32 cores. That is heavy metal. And I just want to show this off because we will be giving this away, a special edition.
So this Threadripper. Limited edition, second gen Ryzen Threadripper, create with heavy metal.
Right.
And it's got our tour calendar on the back. It's got the concert tour calendar.
And of course, this is the cool thing, folks. We're going to be giving this away. Check this out. Oh, hey, there really is a tour.
No, I was serious about
that. Is there a bus that goes around?
No, these are real dates. These are events. No, if you check it out, it's got Sig Graph on here, PAX West, etc. So these are CES, Las Vegas. So this is the real set of upcoming events where we'll be talking more about the product. So
it really is like, and I will say.
Yeah, Computex Taipei.
It was like a rock star event downstairs. Jim and Lisa had the new parts and they were mobbed on the stage. Yeah, and we got them to sign because this shirt, they actually signed Lisa Su here, and Jim signed. He didn't put his full signature because he was afraid you were going to forge it and put it on a check. So, no, not on there. But we will be giving this away in a future podcast. But this is just like, this is like, you guys really, I got to say, you really brought the house down today. I mean,
it was like
being at a Led Zeppelin concert and like, and going into the encore and just like, you
we
just needed to like
that.
Put a cape over yourself and go off the stage. Like,
I love it.
So
good.
Cool.
Thank you, Gordon.
Thanks, folks. And expect full coverage of the brand new 32-core Threadripper chip on PCWorld.com.